Welcome to Redlands, California, today and yesterday. Over 200 years ago, there were no towns or houses when the Serranos and the Kaweah Indians arrived from the other side of the San Bernardino Mountains. The Indians came here because there were more things to eat: acorns, pine nuts, wild animals, and birds. They called their new home Wachama, or place of plenty to eat. The Indians felt that Wachama had been made especially for them by God, and they should never leave. Between 1819 and 1820, priests from the San Gabriel Mission built a mission farm in our valley, grew crops, and raised cattle. From them, the Indians learned how to grow their own crops and raise cattle for food. Soon, a 12-mile ditch was dug from Mill Creek to the mission farm to get water to the fields. The waterway was named the Zanja. Today, we often call it the Zanki. We can still see the Zanja today as it flows through Redlands at Sylvan Park. The priests called the small mission outpost the San Bernardino Estancia. It was located at the Indian village of Wachama. The Lugo family, very hard-working ranchers, bought the land after the priests left. They raised many cattle and beautiful horses at the Estancia and in the valley. An area of Redlands called Lugonia is named after them. The Indians and the early settlers found the land good for growing vegetables and raising animals. However, it was not until 1855 that the first orange trees were planted. A lady named Mrs. Van Leuven visited Los Angeles and brought back the seeds of an orange which she planted near her house. These seeds grew into nice trees, and soon there were many orange trees growing in our valley. Redlands people also began to grow other fruits and nuts: apricots, pears, walnuts, figs, olives, nectarines, lemons, and plums. People moving to Redlands always had to live near the Zanja, since it was the only supply of water in the valley. In 1881, two men, Mr. Frank Brown and Mr. Edward Judson, thought of a way to get water from the mountains to Redlands. They built a dam in the mountains at Bear Valley. The dam held back the water instead of letting it run to the ocean through the Santa Ana River. It was very hard work to build a dam in the mountains, since there were no trucks or machines. For 3 years, mules pulled wagons up to Bear Valley and back until the dam was finished. Big Bear Lake now fills the Bear Valley behind the Big Bear Dam. With the dam complete and more water available, the land began to look green and people continued to move to Redlands. The early settlement was named Redlands for the red clay soil. Several other settlements called Terracina, Mentone, Crafton, and Lugonia also were started. In 1885, the first store opened in Redlands, and 3 months later, there were 40 more. Redlands also had churches and the first public school. Because there were very few roads, the children walked through the fields or rode horses or mules to get to school. The first train service came to the Redlands area in 1876, and 8 years later, the first shipment of oranges was sent out. Since there were no refrigerator cars on the trains, fruits such as apricots, peaches, and grapes were dried in the sun, as in this picture, so they could be shipped without spoiling. By 1888, Redlands had a weekly newspaper, the YMCA, and a post office. The train carried people between Redlands and San Bernardino. Business people from Chicago settled our downtown area and named our main street State Street, after that great street in Chicago. Today, State Street is our busiest shopping area. Our valley had many little settlements, but no main town. Redlands and Lugonia were located side by side, and the other settlements were spread around them. People thought these settlements should be incorporated and become one town. On November 26, 1888, the voters decided to combine the settlements of Redlands and Lugonia and name the new town Redlands. The people of Redlands were very excited to keep their name. They celebrated by banging on pots and pans and blowing horns and yelling to show their happiness. Mr. Judson, the first mayor of Redlands, helped make our town clean and beautiful by telling people to clean up their yards and get rid of trash and weeds. He even gave away free trees to be planted along the streets to make them look pretty. The people of Redlands were proud of their beautiful city. In 1889, Redlands had a veterinarian, a dentist, a barber shop, a laundry, and its first street lamp. The first medical doctor was a woman named Dr. Seymour. That year, the fire department got a fire wagon, and the firemen pulled the hook and ladder themselves. Unless the fire was very far away, then it was pulled by horses. There was no real fire station until 13 years later, when the city built one with fancy doors that opened automatically when the driver sat down in the seat of the fire wagon. The station even had a stained glass window over the stairway and a bell on top to call the volunteer firemen. Now Redlands had a streetcar system that went from the center to the edge of town because people didn't have cars. Most people traveled by wagon, horse, train, bicycles, or they walked. The streetcar was pulled by mules and later run by electricity. We also had a telephone exchange so people could telephone one another. By 1890, Albert and Alfred Smiley, who were identical twins from the eastern United States, were spending their winters in Redlands. People told them apart by the shape of the pocket watch charms they wore on chains across their vests. Albert wore a round charm, Alfred a square one. The Smiley brothers built a gorgeous park called Canyon Crest. They borrowed money to pay for the library building and donated land for a park in downtown Redlands. Because of all the things they did for Redlands, they are called the patron saints of our city. And we celebrate their birthday every year on March 17th, which is also St. Patrick's Day. Authors, inventors, musicians, and actors lived in Redlands. Rich people came to spend the winters here too. They built huge mansions, many of which are still here. Here are some pictures of those houses then and now. People came to our valley for their health, especially in the winter, because warmer weather made them feel better. The tradition of saying the flag salute every day at school began in Redlands. As part of a nationwide celebration for Christopher Columbus' discovery of America, a special salute to the flag was said by schoolchildren all across the country. Mary Fackler's first grade class at Kingsbury School continued to say the flag salute after the celebration was over. It is the same flag salute we say today. In the early 1900s, three United States presidents came to visit Redlands. President McKinley, President Theodore Roosevelt, and President Taft. There were parades, speeches at the Casa Loma Hotel, and tours of our beautiful city. By 1907, Redlands citizens wanted a university. Jasper Newton Field, minister of the First Baptist Church, persuaded the American Baptists to begin the University of Redlands with the help of $100,000, which was raised by the citizens of Redlands. Today, the university has grown larger, but still has many of its original buildings. As the years went by, Redlands became more modern. This was downtown Redlands in 1911. There were a few horse-pulled wagons left. Now, nearly everyone owned a car. With many schools, churches, stores, and factories, Redlands had become a big town. Since there were no televisions or movies for recreation, people had to think of other fun activities. They enjoyed hunting, fishing, playing football and baseball, running races, racing with horses and wagons, bicycling, competing in gymkhanas, which are games played on horseback, lawn bowling, giving plays, and archery. If you remember that Redlands began as bare land with just a few trees surrounded by mountains, you know that it took a lot of hard work and time to build the town we love. Today, Redlands has changed a great deal. It's still a beautiful town. We have big trees, pretty flowers, parks, and many interesting places to visit. Here we see the Redlands Bowl, Prospect Park, and Sylvan Park. If we look carefully, we can see things that remind us of old Redlands. Some of the old stone curbs are still along the streets. When these curbs were first built, the streets were just dirt. Now they've been paved. Many other old things are here for us to see, such as the walls at Smiley Heights. This is where Canyon Crest Park, built by the Smiley twins, used to be. We will also find old buildings in Redlands, such as the Finney Building. Many are in good shape because their owners have taken very good care of them. One of these is the Edwards Mansion, which has been moved from its original location. It was cut in half, moved out of town, put back together again, and turned into a restaurant. Another famous one is the Maury House. It's on Terracina Street, not too far from the hospital. This very beautiful and unusual house has been used in several movies. And Smiley Library is still the building that the Smiley brothers built in 1898. When you travel through the streets of Redlands, watch carefully to see how many signs of old Redlands you can find. The people who started the settlement of Redlands wanted it to be special. They developed a wonderful town, which is a good place to live. We feel just as proud of Redlands today as they did over 100 years ago.